from WBRI 1500 in Indianapolis.
The Martin Bender Band Share Show.
Yeah. Here we are again, another week beginning with Zender Sheridan. Always makes for a good week.
We're still on the air. Yes. Do you know the people we stay with? Joe and Cheryl.
Yeah.
Fuller. You know, Joe knew Neil Armstrong. He graduated from Purdue.
He knows Neil Armstrong.
Yeah. Right.
He knew and knows.
He knows Neil Armstrong.
What is it, a perfect tense?
I don't know.
He knew and knows him continually.
Whatever you say.
Exactly.
He has pictures of him and Cheryl on the golf course with Neil and his wife signed to him. They were fraternity buddies at Purdue.
Yeah, the question is,
Where were you?
Does Neil Armstrong know who we are? That's the real question.
Well, he soon will.
Okay.
What were you doing during the moon landing?
What was I doing during the moon landing? Not listening to Led Zeppelin, that's for sure.
Well, how old were you when the moon landed?
I wasn't born yet. No.
You missed the 70s were awesome. The 70s was the best decade for music ever, I think.
Let me just say that. For those who think that, you've been smoking too much of your own product.
What do you got? What problem do you have with that?
The 70s were disco.
Disco, what is wrong with Funky Town?
The 70s music stinks.
Who would not want to live in Funky Town?
Me, I wouldn't want to live in Funky Town.
Well, you can take me down to Funky Town any day. The 70s produced Brick House.
Yeah.
Are you going to disparage a decade that produced Brick House?
Isn't that where people, you know, use the bathroom?
No, it's a Brick House.
You're too young to understand.
You're too young to understand. Led Zeppelin is one of the awesomest groups of
the 70s. One of the worst ever.
What?
One of the worst ever.
I said Led Zeppelin.
One of the worst live bands.
How can
ever
you say
too.
That?
They're terrible.
Led Zeppelin's terrible?
Horrible.
What about Whole Lotta Love? That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, it's about, what, three chords in that song?
Oh, jeez. Okay, well, those guys knew how to play three chords,
yeah,
all right?
Genius.
We're going to go back to Elizabeth's letter. We keep promising to tie up loose ends, and we honestly try.
Well, if we wouldn't waste our time with the 70s music, see what the 70s have done? The 70s have only prolonged and postponed the revelation of truth, like this program. 70s music has put, it's like Satan has hindered the truth because of the music that you like.
With the 70s.
Yeah.
We use the 70s.
So let's
get
to the truth now.
All right.
Come on.
All right.
Brother.
Duh.
I'm sorry for all you listeners.
Sorry.
But you have to put up with this.
I'm sorry, people. I apologize. Yeah. I sidetracked God.
Next time I will make sure I pick a better co-host for my show, so forgive me for my lack of discernment. All right, what are we doing now?
According to Paul, according to Elizabeth, this is Elizabeth. Remember Elizabeth, the letter we started 2 weeks ago?
We're still.
You know what's scary? We've been 2 weeks on one question.
I bet you Elizabeth and Deb from Anchorage are probably going to therapy classes because of being neglected by Zender Sheridan.
Our answers are so – no, we are so – they're just so in-depth. Where do you get this kind of in-depth study? The mailbag came, brought us a whole pile of letters. We've been on the same letter for going on 3 weeks. The mailbag. Yeah, that's a pretty good imitation.
Okay.
Close.
All right, what are we doing?
All right, listen to this paragraph.
Okay, if I must.
From Elizabeth's letter.
All right, Lizzie.
According to Paul, that's not very nice.
What?
Lizzie.
All right, Elizabeth.
Oh, that's nice, Elizabeth. I'm sorry, maybe it was nice. Maybe she likes to be called Lizzie.
I have no idea. Go ahead.
According to Paul, salvation is not an offer.
Amen.
It's not a sale. It's a done deal.
Good.
That can't be undone by unbelief.
I like her already.
Faith makes the reality experiential. Oh, there's another one of those words. Ooh, I like that word. It's a $10 word, but we need to probably talk about it. Faith makes the reality experiential in one's life in the form of spiritual peace, not an escape from suffering. But a lack of faith doesn't change the reality one iota. The lack of faith does not change the reality one iota. My question to you, Dan Sheridan,
yes, sir.
What reality is she talking about that faith cannot change one iota?
I would imagine what she, and I can't read her mind, but I think, judging the tone of the letter, she means that our faith does not change the reality of what Christ accomplished. Whether we believe or we don't believe, Christ still did what he did, and what we do does not alter, add to, subtract from the accomplishments of Christ.
Let me run an analogy past
okay.
you. I don't know if we've ever
Was that what you're trying to get at?
Yeah, that was a beautiful answer.
Okay.
I'm wiping away the tears.
All right.
The analogy we're often given, we might have talked about this before, I don't know, but we have new listeners, so we're going to talk about it again because it's important. The analogy that Christianity gives for the salvation deal is that God offers you a gift. They say salvation's a gift, but you have to accept it, just like a birthday present.
Yeah.
If somebody gives you a present, it's up to you to unwrap it and do this, or else you don't get it. But the proper analogy is that God, that's a wrong analogy, the one I just gave you.
Yeah.
The right analogy is that God has deposited $1 million in your bank account, and it is in your account. You are now wealthy, and your belief brings it to an experience, like Elizabeth, Liz, uses here, an experiential reality. You're rich, but you don't live as if rich because you don't know about it. It doesn't make it true because
sure.
you're rich. It's in your account. You go to the bank. There's your name. There's the balance, $1 million. It's been that way for 50 years. Too bad nobody told you about it.
Right.
That's the right analogy. And when you believe it, we'll say, why didn't you tell me I had this money in here? I've been living like a poverty-stricken nobody.
Can I go a little contrary to that statement?
I'm gonna send you to funky town.
I'll have my bell bottoms ready. Let me just say this. From God's perspective, yes, it's already there. But it does say in the scriptures, if I may, you know, maybe we can debate this a little bit.
Go for it.
You and I, we both agree that we are, as believers in Christ, we are there. We have these wonderful riches because of what Christ accomplished, and God has given us the faith to believe it. And this was his determination long ago.
Right. Long before the 70s.
However, and I...